The survey that was sent out from Stanford University, the data from that told us that we get maths anxiety within not just Air Authorities but across Scotland, and we were very much aware of that.
So Renfrewshire Council chose to get involved in mindset, particularly with kind of reference to kind of mathematics and numeracy, for a number of reasons. It's part of the kind of wider strategic vision that we have for reducing the poverty related attainment gap and for increasing attainment for all, and we felt that kind of by using a kind of growth mindset approach, you're able to then kind of build resilience with learners.
We had a real group of children who had disconnected from learning, and it became most apparent round about the primary 5-6 stage, where they had the perception of themselves that they weren't clever, and then it became very apparent, why would I be involved in education? Why would I keep going?
We thought that growth mindset was a good fit for the attitude we wanted the children to take towards their maths work.
It was a perfect match. We were trying to create environments within our establishments where it was safe to make mistakes within maths. We wanted children to explore, understand, and deepen their knowledge of why maths is so important today.
There's a lot of negativity about maths, particularly amongst the parents' generation rather than amongst the children. When you talk to parents at parents' night, they're often inclined to say, "Oh, I was no use at maths at school, so I'm sure he or she will be no use at maths at school either."
The biggest impact that I've seen in growth mindset has been the enthusiasm of children in learning. And one of the things that started us was the low-level behaviours of children who were disengaged, and that we don't have that anymore. We have children in classes who want to learn and who encourage one another to learn.
It seems to be working really well. Their engagement and participation is working really well, and this is now having an effect on their attainment as well. It seems like it's intrinsic to them.
In my class, I like to get the children to share their mistakes with others. So I'll ask the children, has anybody made a mistake that they'd like to come and talk to the class about and explain what they did wrong and what it is they've learnt from it, and get the children to say at the end of the week, what have you learned? And they realise that if they've made mistakes, they have learned something.
So the impact we've seen from Mindset Maths is that the children are much more confident in maths, they enjoy it more, they really look forward to maths lessons, working in their groups and leading their own learning. We find that the children are so open to sharing the mistakes, that we call them our marvellous mistakes, and they're dying to tell you what they've done wrong and how they found out they've done it wrong and what they're going to do now to make it better.
Now, the culture in the classroom has completely changed. I did ask the class the other day who liked maths, and without a word of a lie, they all put their hand up.
I've got one boy who handed in a piece of work that I've got on my wall now, and he drew a sad face at the top of it because he felt that it was hard and he felt that he wasn't able to do it, and he went back and added a happy face later on because he realised that although it had been hard, he'd actually learned a lot from doing that piece of work. He was someone that wasn't used to ever getting something wrong, and he kind of picked up that day that it was not a bad thing that he'd got something wrong.
One particular child, he lacked confidence a lot in maths, and refused to do some of the tasks. At the beginning, when I was giving him like open middle tasks, he wouldn't even take part. He wouldn't take part in the group. He would just sit by himself and he would do something else. Whereas now he engages in the task and he's not scared to make a mistake. Like, he actually really enjoys making a mistake.
The impact on mindset so far in attainment has been children attempting to do it a different way, to use a different strategy, to be more creative, to be more just kind of thinking outside the box and how they approach things, more collaborative, and you know, kind of building that kind of environment and the kind of work that they do.
What we're seeing is a greater resilience being built in children in terms of their math skills, and I think that's been, it's not really just about maths, because this extends across their life and across the curriculum.
What Heriot would like to achieve next, it's really important for us that all staff feel empowered to be able to confidently deliver a growth mindset approach within their classrooms. So we feel that by equipping all staff with the skills and ensuring that they have got access to courses and sharing of good practice, that will then filter out positively to our children.
Next in school, our plans are to do more of the same. We're keeping on our growth mindset journey, not just in maths, but I think it does pervade the whole ethos of our school. We see it in kids coming in, telling you about how they can now tie their shoelaces or swim or you know, they can now ride their bike. So we see it having an impact on their, you know, their entire life.
I think, like, teaching growth mindset within focusing on maths has made a massive difference to me and to my class. Like, even the way I teach, like, using different strategies, it's worked really, really well. So I would definitely, if you have the chance, I would grab it and do it.
If a school hasn't started their growth mindset journey yet, I would say there is so much evidence to show that it makes such a big impact on your children.
Growth mindset's a lifelong skill. Once you've got that within you, it should serve forever. What I would say is it's not an overnight success. It will take time. It takes perseverance with it. And bit by bit over the years, you will see an impact, and we certainly have.
I would be looking at exactly where you are on your own journey with growth mindset, what your own values and visions are as your school, and making sure that all of your senior leadership team are absolutely on board with this, of course, and then engage with your staff, and I suppose just giving a really positive picture of what can be achieved through delivering a growth mindset.
I think it's important that we give people the opportunity to succeed and maximise their potential in life, and this really does see it through. If we've got teachers who are positive about children's learning experiences, it doesn't have to be maths teachers, this goes across the board throughout our nurseries, our primaries, our secondaries, then we need to give our children that opportunity.